Okay, yeah, two-phase name lookup for C++ templates is two or three people told me beforehand that they don't know what I'm talking about now, and this is very reassuring, because the worst feeling, the worst case for a lightning talk is when you get the feeling everybody knows already everything that you are telling them. So at least three people don't know what I'm talking about. Okay, I'm Uwe Schnittger. I'm with a platform software development group here, and Bernd will tell you a little bit more about what we do and how we do it. But one thing that we do is programming C++ and switching to C++ 17. And when we did this with Visual Studio, I tried not only to set the standard here, C++ 17, but also to set the permissive minus flag, which sets conformance, enables conformance mode. And this has an interesting effect, because it turns on the two-phase name lookup for templates. Okay, now, two-phase name lookup, if you Google this, you will find out it was already in the 1998 standard. So what's new? Why? But I mean, template, partial template specialization was also in the standard already in 1998. And I think Microsoft managed to get this ready in, I don't know, 2005 or 8 or something like this. So it was in 10 or 15 years. And so now they are ready for the two-phase name lookup. Okay, what does it mean? Okay, I want to talk about the difference between the template definition time and the template instantiation time, because that are the two phases that are named. Then about the syntax checking that is done already at the template definition time. I will talk about dependent names versus non-dependent names. And what happens with overload set changes. Okay, and also about dependent base classes. That's the point. Now, I don't like it when we have only example functions foo and bar and bas and something like this. So I made a little example up for myself. I have here a half plane and class. And the idea is here you have two points which define a line, which is the edge of the half plane. And you have a point here, and you want to know if it's on the edge or if it's contained. And of course, we make this a template because we want to use different point types. So that's our example here. We will not do proper computational geometry. That's not the point here, because I mean, you know, then you need things like robust algorithms and numerics and kernels, infinite precision kernels or something like this. No. It's just an example. Okay. One reminder, you can use complex numbers as 2D points, either with a real and image. Okay, I want the laser pointer here. Where am I? Here? Ah, yeah, okay. Kaum macht man es richtig, schon funktioniert. The real and imaginary part of the complex number, or you can have the radius and the angle. And because just using a 2D vector with x and y is just boring, so no boring stuff here. Okay, now what is template definition time versus template instantiation time? Template definition time is when the compiler sees here this include. It has to pass the include file, and the old version, when you don't enable the conformance mode in Visual Studio, it just says, oh, there's some template code, I will just put it aside. And whenever I need it, I will take it and compile it and do checking on this, basically. And the standard says something different. You have to pass the code and you have to do some checking on this. Oh. When we talk about checking, please someone check me on the time. Okay, so this is the template definition time, and the instantiation time is, for one point, when you use the templates here, the template class, and also the member functions are only instantiated when they are actually used, actually called. So we have here this different times, and in different times, different kinds of syntax checking and name resolution are performed. Okay, the compiler can of course not fully compile the code from a template when it does not know for which type to instantiate it. And of course, there will be some change when concepts are added in C++, because then the compiler knows what the template parameter, what function it has from the concepts. But no, right now it's not possible. But the compiler can flag errors that are independent of any instantiation. I made here again an example. Here in this function, we make a comparison with an operator that doesn't exist. So this is always an error. This is wrong syntax. In this case, we ask the point for the x and y. Again, this computation here doesn't make sense. This is not a correct algorithm. But here, it is point x and point dot y. And only if this function is actually, when the compiler knows what point type is used, can it check this, if this is correct or not. And so if you look at this, here we have the header included, here we have the two complex types included. So the error, this error here with the wrong spelled operator, is already checked here with the correct compiler setting. The Microsoft compiler did this wrong. And because it did this wrong, you wouldn't find such an error if the function was never instantiated. This is how I got interested in this topic, because it happened to us. We had a function which was never called, a template function, and it was bad, but the compiler never complained, even if it should have. And on the other hand, this function that wants a point type with x and y coordinates will only compile, the compiler will only get the error when it is called here. What's the type of the instantiation? Okay, a little further, going a little further with our example to show some more interesting stuff. How is this isContained member function implemented? Of course, again, the correct way you would have to look into computational geometry. We won't do this. I just have a silly idea here. We have two points on a perpendicular line, equidistant from the edge. And now I just check the distance from the outer point and from the inner point. And if the distance from the inner point is smaller, then it's contained. So very simple and probably very error prone. Okay, how will we do this? We can write this isContained function within distance. I check here the distance of the test point to the point I want to ask about. And here's the outside point, and I compare the distance. I didn't include the isOnEdge function right here because I don't want to know if I don't want you to ask me if I'm on edge now. Okay, if we write this, we need overloads for the distance function for our different types. We have the Cartesian and the polar complex classes, so we need to implement the distance classes functions, and then they can be called here. And what happens now is, okay, this was the first point, okay, with the distance. And if we want to avoid rounding errors, then we should do, again, proper computational geometry, but I won't do this. I'll just use here some function is not significantly greater than to check the distances. And yeah, an approximation function, some fancy mass. Ah, thank you. Very good. Okay, so this is the way I want rounding errors. And now we have the interesting case with the dependent and independent or non-dependent names. The dependent names, are the distance functions, or the distance function, because this depends on the template parameter. These are points here, and the is not significantly greater than function takes two doubles, so it's not dependent on the template parameter. And the interesting thing is that the dependent names are bound at instantiation time, of course, because only then do we know what the template parameter is. But the non-dependent names are not dependent on any template parameter, so the compiler can check them and bound them at the definition time. And this was wrong without the permissive flag. And what does this mean? Here, before I include the header of the template with the template, I have to define the function that is non-dependent, because otherwise it will not be bound. And the function, the distance function here, can be defined later on. And typically, you, all these function declarations are in headers, so it is a question of the sequence of the headers. If you have the wrong header first, then it will not compile. And if you have overloaded functions here, here I have two of these approximation functions. I should really, okay. Okay. Oh. I should find the laser pointer here. If you have two overloaded functions and we call them here, then we expect in this case the first overload with a double. I put in with a double. The second to be called, okay. We expect the correct overload to be called, but if the overload loaded functions are, in this case here, I have the first function here and the second function here after the template is included. And in this case, the overload set will not include the second function because the name is already bound by the template definition time. And this means that the wrong overload is used here. And another point with the two-phase name lookup is, which is also an now with the conformance switch which we will use, is that dependent base classes are not checked. I put this function here. Oh, sorry. Okay, I could now complain about the user interface design for this thing, but I will refrain from that. I put this function here in a class and make this class a base class for our template class. This is obviously very bad class design, so we always should favor composition over inheritance, but just for the sake of the presentation. And now the point is, these names here are not, in the dependent base class scope, the names are not searched. So the compiler looks for a free function with this name. And there are two possible cases. Either it finds one, then you have a problem because it's probably the wrong one you didn't want to use, or it doesn't find some, then it goes boom. Okay, what you have to do in this case is here to use this this pointer, an explicit this explanation here. Looks a little bit like Python code, then, and then you get the desired result. There are a lot more examples about where you must put type name and template keywords in there, but I think the time is already running out, and so that's so I will stop at this. Okay, thank you.